Hello, everybody. My name is Jonathan Morrison, and welcome to the John John Cast. And this podcast, I'll be covering the Fortnite Battle Royale, and we'll bring a breaking news story from YouTube that was brought earlier today. So, without further ado, let's get right into this topic about Fortnite Battle Royale from TheXerso.com. The title of the article is claiming that Fortnite Battle Royale is not addictive. It says, without doubt, the most popular game in the world right now is Fortnite Battle Royale. But according to a researcher at a UK university, it is not necessarily addictive. Often the criticism of these games is that they take over the minds of young people everywhere because they are addicting, and that spending too much time playing them is a sign that players are unable to pull themselves away from the screen. So basically what he is saying, basically the kids who are playing Fortnite, that it's supposed to be rated for T-15, that kids should not be playing it because that's cartoon violence, because I agree with the... So, Fortnite has certainly been blasting with such criticism, primarily from the mainstream media, who are keen to warn parents of the concerns that playing too much or becoming addicted might have for their kids. So basically, what they're trying to say is this is impacting their lack of activity and outside, basically falling away from their schooling and lack of activity going outside. And also, he mentioned it, and here it says, Good Morning America recently featured a section dedicated to the game where they presented Fortnite as a real issue, distracting school children from their priorities and damaging their social life, which I basically agree with them. Of course, this is nothing new when it comes to some mainstream representations and games. I'll link to this article in the description. On my comments. Also, breaking news from YouTube.com. Breaking news from YouTube. On Twitter, they announced that they're saying that people who are seeing this 500 error message on YouTube, it's a 500 internal server error, which when you're trying to click on a person's YouTube channel, basically, you cannot click on it, it will give you an error message. Also, they mentioned that channels are facing the errors. Note that the videos are watchable and accessible. It's only channel pages that are resulting in the error message, so you should be able to click on the title, thumbnail, etc. to watch the video, just not the channel name. So basically, they should be able to have when you click on the channel name, there should be fixed by now. That's all we have this time of this podcast. If you like this podcast, make sure you subscribe and make sure notifications turned on. Subscribe to my podcast below, and I'll see you guys in the next podcast.